Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. The network interface terminal there. I've already explored that, so we'll continue on. Still looking for Mirak. Broken medical supplies and radiation detectors are lying on a round table. Apparently the table is this way. Nice! We've got first aid kits. Now Epsilon has one. He only has three in them. Who's the second fastest person? Second. Okay. Speed 163, because I'm going to give the second fastest person the three bandages, whatever. Okay, it's Epsilon. Off the scale here. That's just not redrawn from before. 62. 271. 515 for Varanus. Alright, Varanus would be a good fit for this. He's another one that's, can't really stand up in a toe-to-toe fight, but he's got the magic. So, oh wait. Okay, this is three bandages. As far as I know, I can't split these up, otherwise I'd make them more or less equal. You know, six and seven or something, but I don't know if there's a way to split them up. I couldn't figure it out. So, it might not be like that. I'll give Epsilon this one. Oh. A credit card with 3,000 credits. Good. Because we just about ran out of money. After, oh, I'll give it to Killdozer. Just about ran out of money after our last network session. Oh, it's a security card, no. Oh, it disappeared. Oh, I guess it disappears and gets added to the credit list. Or credits. Which is another thing. I don't know where you can see that. The credits you have? I usually would list it in, like, an inventory screen like this. Oh, account, 3150 credits, and I think, oh, he's got 5,000. We have separate amounts. Oh, so if you run out of money, just switch to another character, I guess. I thought it was just, I thought they shared the credits, and I didn't realize you could see it here. Alright, cool. Nothing else in here? Alright. Then we depart. Broken medical supplies. I guess we found some unbroken ones. Spooky. You almost stumble over the scattered equipment here. Killdozer, you're so clumsy. This way. Mm-hmm. axe grenades? Huh. Is it filled with the body spray? That'll work. Well, I'll give them to Killdozer. There's only two. We got more here. Empty code battery? Oh, let's look at the code battery. I thought I was timing my exploits. It stopped for some reason, I don't know. Empty code battery, 0.20 kilograms. That's nothing much to say about that. Okay. So I've got these grenades. Can't combine them as far as I know, so we got two. He's got three stacks of two grenades. Two kilograms, 80% speed factor. Why? Average wounding is zero, range is zero? How could the range be zero on a grenade? Maybe it's not meant for combat use. That's all you're saying. Forgive me, but this ammo does not fit into that item. Could it be... axe grenade. Could it be for what's his name's gun? Twin Snake's gun? Rex, regular carbine. Beast 4, assault gun. With ammo. So they don't call it grenades, they call it ammo. Yeah, Beast 4 power card. Unless it also takes grenades. I'm not sure. Alright, I'm gonna just leave as is then. Alright, just wanna make sure I don't leave anything in the analyze screen. Well, that's interesting. Grenades. It could indeed be an item, like a weapon, or maybe something to use somewhere, because they do have some, like, adventure game type. Things like puzzles and items to use in certain places. Different signs let you know that this is a medical cabinet. There's also a door. What's this way? This side tunnel leads into the heart of this mine. Oh, it goes down. We got an elevator down. Okay. So before we go there... let's check this out. Medical cabinet. Well, that's cool. We could use some more stuff, some more bandages and things. I just want to look at something. So Epsilon has this with 10 bandages, and Varanus has this with 3 bandages. Okay, cool. Just wanted to make sure that was the case. Okay, see what's in a medical supply. Organism detector. Oh, brother. Okay, hello there. That's a nice doggy. You enter the chamber to face a nightmare. An old one-eyed man is fighting a pack of hideous werewolf-like creatures in a desperate attempt to save a little boy. Probably his grandson, who is hiding behind his back. Lycanthropes, huh? Despite his considerable martial arts skills, the old man loses his balance and tumbles down under the ferocious blows. Then, one of the beasts grasps the defenseless little child and disappears in a dark air shaft together with its screaming prey. The rest of the creatures turn against their new target, you. Everything happens so damn fast, you barely can blink. Now I'd like to do this to see their responses. I miss people actually, or beings actually, answering us. But, Varanus talked to him, right? These monsters doesn't seem to be in a talking mood. Got a lot of lycanthropes in the network document. It just says the same thing. Okay. Okay, how about the miscreants? Just three of them? Okay. So this is Epsilon, right? Was that in his way? Oh wait. Since he has so much speed, I'm just gonna check these things out. Those two over there. He's getting even more speed. More speed, man! More speed! This is why he's got all these bandages. He could run around and reach anybody unless somebody's in his way. He's getting speedier by the moment. $17.96 speed. Wow. He just went up over 500. That's crazy. I need to share this speed with some of the other people here. Oh, he can't make it through there. That's a problem. We can get him some speed as well. The more speed they get, the more speed they can get, because then they can move more and get even more speed. Rune Claw. Ton of life force drain. A lycanthrope prepares for a range attack. Lycanthrope is taking no action. And we got two range attacks coming. What kind of range attack would a werewolf have? So now we got vampires, now we got werewolves. He definitely needs more speed, this guy. And Advent. Well, at least we got out of Varanus' way. The lycanthrope lets out a terrible wail. Rune claws be assaulted by unendurably extreme sound. A horrible, deadly howl. Well, it hit two of us. Oh, jeez. Now this one go... Missed? Okay, good. Epsilon and Rune Claw. Looks like... We finally get to go? That's very nice of you. Where is it affecting his stamina, right? Down from 205 to 157. Vitality only down by 1. His speed is up because he increased his maximum, that's why. Alright, well, he can take some more of that. It went down about a quarter. And then Rune Claw was the other one affected. Oh, Rune Claw needs to get a heck out of dodge soon. His strength is down, too. Affect his strength? And that's not his real speed. Alright. Vitality. So, this is... Okay. Alright, that's... Letter... Oh! That's right! He's melee only. He's using the knife. I forgot about that. His vitality's not hurt. Or stamina. He's gonna have to run up and... Oops, wrong thing. I forgot. At least we got this guy preparing to do a range attack. Oh, he hit his own friend. Look at that. And he didn't hit... He didn't hit... What's his name? He didn't hit Killdozer. Okay, so this is a tunnel of life force drain. So, if we hit this one and... If we hit this one, it should get both of them. I'm hoping. Lycanthrope unaffected. I guess both of them. Alright. So much for that. We need to get going before we get knocked out here. Oh, I don't think he can reach that far. Nope. How about an alpha catharsis then. Varanus. Cone of Sonic Boom. Okay, Epsilon. Can finally start attacking these guys. Yeah, how do you like that? How do you like them apples? Get the speed. This guy is like the Flash running around here. Because a round casts takes just as long. It's the character who's sped up. He killed his friend! You killed your teammate. Missed. Alright, so this... He's gonna heal... what's his name over here? I have to remind myself what their battle icons look like. Rune Claw. Okay. That's Rune Claw. So heal Rune Claw. It's a cone. Which is cool because you can heal two people at once or more than, you know, multiple. A moment of perfect balance. Anyone else need it? I'm sure. I can't believe the one werewolf killed the other. That's amazing. Yeah, I'll save it for now. Down that much. He was the one who was really affected. I mean, technically we could give Epsilon some. I think I'll wait though. Yeah, you can't move. Okay. Oh, right. Physical. Forgot. Alright. Oh, I don't want to hurt him with the bombs. I hope I don't. Well done. I don't want to hit our friend here. Hopefully this won't hit him. Missed. Oh, it only hit that one? Running around him. Varanus. I didn't want Varanus to get hit, really. He hit his friend. Oh, something about his claws and his gnarly something. He's holding his own. Pretty sweet. But he still can't reach, he needs to get closer. Close! No cigar. Oops. Alright, so this is a cone of sonic boom. Hopefully it doesn't hit him. Ah, unaffected. Is he unaffected because it doesn't work on them, or it's just I missed? Oh, I think I could have just attacked. They're more susceptible to their own attacks than we are to their attacks. I mean, this is almost like cheating. I haven't killed any of them. They killed themselves. This is only the second time we've hit them. Of course it's Epsilon. .2389 speed. Oh my god. I'm waiting for the others to get like this. The attack on Runeclaw is missed. Varanus fell. That's no good. Oh, with his physical attacks. Oh, man. We can't do it. We can't do it. I have to start over. I wish there was a way to bring party members back. You know, after combat or whatever. And this would be a non-issue. Otherwise, we'd be walking around with five characters for the rest of the game. Okay, here we are again. This thing sticks. Doesn't always register a click for some reason. I don't know if that's an issue with the game or the emulator. But I'm just showing you how Epsilon could just run all over the place around this entire battlefield in one move. And it just gained three more increases to speed.